Hi, I'm Vits, and this is the follow-up discussion to the Vits Awards. As usual, I'm here with my good friend Bradley Falk, who, by the way, has a new YouTube channel called Beyond the Negatives.
First and foremost, and this will make sense if you've seen my video, I know you have, Vits. Leave Honest John alone. Leave him alone. He is precious. I think he was nominated for what? Worst character or something?
Yes.
Like it was worse. Yeah, I was like, what the fuck? Leave Honest John. He's the only good thing about that awful, awful Robert Zemeckis Pinocchio remake. What the fuck? Why did you nominate him? Is it because of that stupid Chris Pine joke? Is that what that is? I hate it too, but like, that's not a reason to hate him. He's great.
The Chris Pine joke was the tip of the iceberg. Actually, when I was watching the movie and he said that, I paused it and I said, you know what? I'm done. Not that I wasn't going to finish the movie. That was always the plan. I meant that I'm done as a film critic. I cannot believe I heard something so stupid. Look, it's not that Honest John didn't have good jokes in the movie. It's just that all the good jokes were from the original. So I can't give them credit for those good jokes. And also, I didn't like the design. Because
oh, you're gonna piss off a lot of furries. You're gonna piss off a lot of furries by saying that.
I'm sure of that. The effects are good, they're just not well used. Because the whole idea of this character is that he's supposed to be, you know, the stranger on the streets who says cool things and leads impressionable children down the wrong path. But because they make him look like a very realistic fox, his smile is so creepy. So why would anyone get near him, let alone trust him?
I mean, I don't even know what to say. I mean, you again, I think I'm not a furry by any means, but I think a lot of furries, regardless of the teeth or the smile or whatever, would be like, oh, please, daddy. Okay, I'm going to shut up now. Because, yeah, I don't want to piss off furries, even though I kind of think I have already. I'm not sure. And you too, probably. But anyway, I looked at your best music score category, and there's some really great scores in there, including Spencer. What was another one? The Batman? That was another one? What the fuck? Why did you pick Don't Look Up for, like, okay. Okay, viewers, Vits's subscribers, it's time to piss you off a little bit. I'm not sure if anyone like agrees with me here or disagrees with me here, but Don't Look Up is fucking overrated and should not have been nominated for as many Oscars as it did. It is truly one of the stupidest and preachy films ever made. I don't disagree with the politics that Adam McKay is putting forward. I disagree with how it's being presented. And how it's presented in the dialogue and, you know, written when it comes to the characters and that sort of thing. But you know what? Let's focus on the score, because I don't remember anything about the score. Now, I understand you nominating Just Look Up in the one of the song categories, because just Look Up, while it's kind of a joke song, it's a good song anyway. And also Ariana Grande is great anyway. But like music score, I don't remember anything about the score. Absolutely nothing.
Overall, I like the composition, and I like that it had a very unique style, at least compared to pretty much every film score I heard in a movie in 2022, because a lot of the other ones, as good as they are, they do feel very similar. You know, that kind of orchestra that they use. Here it was more like jazz music, and that makes it stand out more. And because of the satirical tone and the type of editing they were using, I felt it all came together. I think I felt all these elements complemented each other very well.
I mean, I kind of get it, but then, dude, man, I know we're not really talking about the movies themselves. We're talking about the scores of the films. And, you know, I just think Spencer is just an all-around better movie than Don't Look Up. Okay, Bros, if you don't know, is a Billy Eichner vanity project. He technically co-wrote it with some other person, but really, this is his baby right here, and it's a piece of shit baby, figuratively speaking, of course. It's so unbelievably ranty, and how do I put this, man? And I'm a part of the LGBT community too, so I can criticize this movie, so don't call me homophobic, Billy Eichner. This movie is just 2 hours of Billy Eichner's character, but really Billy Eichner, it's kind of a Malcolm and Marie situation, where he's just ranting about, you know, his grievances being a gay man and being in the gay community and that type of thing. Literally, it's almost 2 hours of nothing but bitching and moaning and occasionally a sex scene. Let's talk about the actual relationship between him and Aaron Shepherd, I think that's the name. It's not very good. The attraction doesn't make sense, at least on the other person's end. When it comes to Billy Eichner being attracted to him and wanting to be with him, I'm like, oh, okay, I get it. I get that. But what in God's name does the other guy see in Billy Eichner? And no, I'm not talking about looks. I'm talking about attitude. I'm talking about personality. Who wants to be with someone who constantly bitches and moans all the time? Exhibit A, me. Me. Who wants to? I mean, I don't think I bitch and moan as much, but my point is that there's no real reason for them to be together. There is no, like, connection. There's no chemistry, whether we're talking about the characters or the actors themselves. They don't have any chemistry together, so I don't really understand how this is a relationship, whether it's you or me or anybody else should vote or should, like, be rooting for. And thank God that Everything Everywhere All at Once won this category, because if somehow Bros won this, I would have lost my mind.
It's acknowledged in the movie, right? He calls him out for always ranting and preaching.
He doesn't really change, though. Billy Eichner doesn't really have much of a character arc in this movie. Not really. I mean, I know he feels bad about it and he sings that stupid song, which also won an award. But, like, aside from stuff, small stuff like that, it's not really an arc, though. It's really not. Maybe he mellows out a little bit, but, like, it's not really felt there. The Batman is a pretty great movie, and I'm glad it won favorite movie. It was great. I think Everything Everywhere All at Once is a better movie, hence why you gave it best movie, and that type of thing. But yeah, The Batman is so fucking good, man. Let's talk about that favorite song winner. And this was the public poll thing, or the public voting thing. How the fuck did a boring song, like As It Was, win favorite song over something like Anti-Hero, which is so fucking good? I remember way back 3 or 4 years ago when you and me started doing this wrap-up after discussion and that type of thing, I told you to grow, and I told you to learn from not just other YouTube content creators, but also have your own identity and, you know, make sure to branch out and, like I said, grow. And you've done that quite a bit with this, especially with the opening montage was great. I think this is probably one of the better opening montages that you've done for this award ceremony. The jokes, I mean, I'm not one to judge. I'm not a comedian by any means. Some jokes landed, some I don't. And even if they didn't, I don't remember exactly what didn't land. But I will say, though, dude, it's hard to talk about the Will Smith and Chris Rock slap thing. It is so, because it doesn't matter whose side you're on, people are going to try to, like, get into your space and be like, actually, this is what this was about. And you can, and you're going to call yourself perfect. What about what you did this? So it's very hostile, no matter whose side you're on, whether you're on Will's side or Chris's side. Like, it doesn't really matter. And that's why most people, at least now in 2023, don't want to talk about it, because it's almost like, you know, you can't win. So I will give you credit and props for having the balls to even make a joke about
Thank you.
it. but yeah, you did wonderful. Make sure to keep a lookout. I'll be uploading stuff. Vits will be uploading stuff, and us together will be working together again very, very soon.
Yes, and I can't wait. Brad, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having me, man.